So before proceeding with the Candy Bowl data, I wanted to take a moment and describe the data that we collected in order to perform this analysis. So if you recall, the goal is to understand what influences consumer choice, in this case, the influencers of candy selection. And so we elected to record any attributes which we thought might possibly have an impact on selection preference. So each record corresponded to someone selecting a candy. For each record, the attributes that we thought to collect, which might have an influence on candy preference, were name, gender, the type of candy. We lumped color and flavor into one giant category, age of the person who's selecting, and ethnicity of the selector. Now, in addition to that attribute, in order to establish a baseline, we also wanted to include a spurious attribute. That way, any attribute that was ranked as having a weaker relationship than that one, we knew that we could safely ignore it. So, as our selection of a spurious attribute, we chose shirt color. I think we can all agree that shirt color shouldn't have an impact on what candy someone selects. So, when we're evaluating the strength of relationships of any one of these other attributes to candy choice, we know that if it has a weaker relationship than that of shirt color, we can safely ignore it. Now, in addition, the records are chronological, meaning that the records appear in the order in which selections were made. Now that you know what all of the attributes mean, go grab a hold of the data yourself so that you can follow along while we do the analysis.